I'm excited about today. We're going to set up a free library that looks like this. It has days worth of tutorials. Everything is linked and categorized. We're going to set it up from scratch using Power Query custom data types. As you're watching this, just think about the possibilities and what you can achieve with these data types. The library that we're going to set up is going to be available 24/7. Okay, so the free library I'm talking about is on my site, excelplus.com. Go to tutorials, free Excel tutorials. Right here, you have the full list. So if I click on this, it's going to download a spreadsheet. Then when we open this, you're going to find the full list of tutorials that I have on YouTube. You see the link here, the category, the main topic. And on the side here, if you scroll over, you see the length of the video, the date, and the link to the blog post. So in case of the Excel tutorials, where it makes sense to include the file as part of the blog post, part of the tutorial, you're going to find the Excel file at the bottom of the blog post. Now, this is fine as it is. You don't really need anything special, right? But we're not going to make it this simple. We actually want to connect live to the file on the site so that whenever this file gets updated, as long as the link to the file stays the same, all you need to do is refresh your query here and you're going to get the list of updated tutorials. Now, I don't update this after each video, but we try to do this at least on a quarterly basis. Now, the idea is to show you how you can do this so that you can use this technique on other files that might be updated on a more frequent basis. There is going to be a problem that we're going to run into, and maybe you already guess what it is. When I connected this data with Power Query, my links are not going to be links anymore. So how can we get around that? Well, there is a trick you can use in Power Query. Let me show you. Open a blank file, go to data, from the Get Data section here, from web. As for URL, we are not going to give it the URL of the page. That's not what we need. Instead, we need the URL to the file. So if I bring up the web page here, when I hover over this on the bottom, notice the link I get. That's what I need. And if I right mouse click, I can copy the link. So let's go back to Power Query, paste it right here, click on OK. This is going to create a direct connection to that file. So as long as the link to the file doesn't change, I'm able to refresh my query and get the latest information. So to this website, we just want to go with anonymous access. That's fine. Let's connect. I have two sheets here and one table. My information there is in a table. So I'm going to select this one and I'm going to want to transform this, but I just want to show you how it looks like if I directly load this into the sheet. It's creating a connection. 294 rows were loaded. Everything looks good except the links here, right? They're not clickable. Even if I click inside, press enter, it obviously doesn't work because the link is incomplete. On the Excel side, if I bring up the workbook I downloaded here, notice that the link is clickable because if I right mouse click, well, actually, we can't see that, so let's go to enable editing. If I right mouse click and go to edit hyperlink, notice the link here. It has a prefix that's missing when I connect with Power Query. And unfortunately, Power Query doesn't yet have a link data type. So what I need to do is copy this part because this is the same for all YouTube videos. They all have the same prefix. I'm going to copy this and update this in my Power Query. Double click this to bring up the query editor. Let's scroll to the side here, link to video, highlight this column, go to transform, format, add prefix. The prefix that I want to add is what I copied, click on OK. Now I get the full link. Now for the blog posts here, I also want to add a prefix. These ones I already know because they're on my site. So I'm going to go to format, add prefix, and quickly type in https://excelplus.com and then OK. Before we send this to Excel and check if they are now clickable or not, let's quickly double check that all of the data types up there are correct. These all look good. Video length is automatically duration, which is day, hour, minute, and second. These are dates. Everything looks good. Let's do one thing, actually. I don't want to see the oldest tutorial first and the newest last, so I'm going to change the sorting of this and sort this in descending order. Okay, so far so good. Does this fix our problem? Close and load. I get the newest tutorials first. Now on the side here, I have my links. Now they're still not clickable, but at least I'm one step further. If I click inside and press enter, they become clickable. So also this one, if I click inside and press enter, they're clickable now. When I click this, I go to the website. Now this is fine, but I want to avoid having to click inside and pressing enter. So let's use a relatively new feature in Power Query to get around this problem. Let's go back to our query and create a custom data type. A custom data type is basically going to condense all this information in a single column. So you're going to see what I mean in a second. I'm going to select everything with Control A, go to Transform, all the way to the end, you're going to see Create Data Type. That's what we want. Now we get to give our data type a name. Since everything is about learning and tutorials, I'm going to call it Tutorials. The column that we want to display, that we want to be the face of our data type, is going to be Tutorial Title. Right? I'm just going to go with that because it makes sense in this case. Under Advanced, you get to see the other columns that I selected. If you don't need anything, you can remove it. You can also adjust the order. So that number here, I'm going to bring all the way to the bottom. I want to have the link to post a bit higher, and also link to video. Let's have that right here. Okay, so far so good. Now check this out. When I click on OK, everything gets condensed in one column. So if I expand this to the side and now click to the side here, we get to see the details on the bottom. In Excel, where would we see that? Or we're going to see it in a new card. Take a look at this. We're going to go back and send this to our workbook. We're going to end up with one column. And now notice these cards. It says show card. So when I click on this, I get to see it. Main topic is Power Automate. It involves Excel, Outlook, and Flow. This is the link to the video, link to the post. Now this again is not clickable yet, but wait. Take a look at this. We can extract this column to the grid. What happens when I do that? Click on the plus here. I get a new column in my Excel table, but again, I'm back where I was, right? It's still not clickable. Well, wait a second. Take a look at the formula bar. There is now a formula behind this. It's referencing the tutorials column, and it says dot link to video. This is the way that you can reference parts of this data, so parts of the card, with a formula. So I can go to the side here, and actually when you're at the end of your table, you also see this add column. If I select that and say add link to post as well, it's gonna automatically add this, so you don't have to be necessarily in the card. You can get this column in different ways. You can also even just type a formula. So if I say equals and then go to the side to tutorials and put in a dot, you automatically see these. So let me just go closer right here. You see these categories. Let's select video length in this case, press enter, and we get all this information here. Okay, so far so good. Now, how can I convert these to links? Well, I'm going to take advantage of the fact that these are formulas, and I'm going to use another formula on top of this, the hyperlink formula. It requires the link location, which is this. Then I can also give it a friendly name. So in this case, I'm going to go with video, close bracket, press enter, and I get the links to the videos. Each one of these has their unique links. Let's do the same here. This time I'm not going to use a friendly name. I'm just going to go with hyperlink, open bracket, put in the formula, close bracket, and I have all the links to the blog posts. Now let's check this out. I'm going to click on this, see if it works. It works. So using custom data types can help us use links in our Power Query results. As a final test, I'm going to update the file on the site and add two new tutorials to it. And then I'm going to come back here and we're going to refresh it and see if all of this works.
A few moments later.
Okay, so I've updated the file on the site. I've cleared the cache of the website. Now notice here we have 294 rows currently loaded. Let's go ahead and refresh this. Right mouse click, refresh, and I should get the two tutorials of last week here, 296 rows loaded. I have the video link. I have the link to the blog post for one of these. The other one doesn't have a blog post. Now, does this link work? This one is about Outlook. Let's click on it. It takes me directly to the video. Okay, so that's one advantage of data types. They come with many more advantages. Because you can use formulas to reference them, you can get quite creative with these in Excel. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial about Power Query's custom data types, which is a relatively new feature in Excel for 365. If you already have some ideas on how you can use this, let me know in the comments. And if you'd like to master Power Query, take a look at my complete course on excelplus.com. Many thanks for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.